Welcome student. Today I am going to discuss a new topic, hierarchy of Java exception class. In the previous lecture, we have covered what is exception, why exception should be handled in such a way that we can execute the normal operation of a program. Why default stack runtime stack mechanism is required? If any method in the program has not handled any exception, then how can I handle the exception? So that means how to handle default exception in Java. All those topic we have already discussed. Now in this lecture, this topic, hierarchy of Java exception class, is very important concept, and it is very essential. As I already mentioned, that this topic need a clear cut idea about the exception, and you will get so many questions from this topic. So before going to discuss about this hierarchy of Java exception, first we have to know that which class the Java exception, or we can say what is the root class of Java exception hierarchy. So in Java exception hierarchy, the root class, that is called throwable. Throwable is a class, and it belongs to which package? Java.lang package. Okay, so java.lang.throwable, and we know that every class in Java, what is the super class? Super class is a object. So this class is also belongs is a child class of object class. So java.lang, the throwable class, is the root class of Java exception hierarchy, which is inherited two subclasses. One of the class is called exception, and another class is called error. So in this lecture, I will discuss in details the hierarchy of Java exception class. I will discuss what are the type of exception, whether it is check exception, whether it is uncheck exception, what is fully check exception, what is partially check exception, what is the difference between the check exception and uncheck exception. That is the most valuable question I am going to discuss in details one by one. So in hierarchy, so I got the superclass, that is throwable, and which has two subclass. One of the class is called exception, another class is called error. Now what is exception? We know an exception is an unwanted event in a program which stop the normal execution of a Java program is called the exception. Unwanted, unexpected event is called exception. But what is error in Java program? That is the most valuable question, because most of the people will get confused error and exception. That is the most common question: what is the difference between the exception and error? So what is error? In this case, error means lack of system resource. Lack of system resource. Suppose we have just you are doing some operation, and in the meantime the system suddenly crash. So here the execution of a program stop abnormally. because you cannot handle it, because the system crashed due to some reason, or I am going to access some memory location which is not available. So out of memory exception, stack overflow exception, virtual machine error. So this type of error is belongs to an error. So exception and error is clear. So exception means unwanted, unexpected event, and error means which lack of system resource. Mainly one term we can say that lack of system resource. We may write this term lack of system resource. System resource. Lack of system resource. So most of the time error is not caused by the programmer. Okay, it is not caused by the program. Under this are lack of system resources. So since it is not caused by the programmer or not caused by the program, so it will not handle or recoverable from the program. So error are not recoverable, but exception is recoverable. We can recover it. So it is recoverable or it is not recoverable. For example, out of memory exception occur, being a programmer, we can't do anything. We can't do anything, the program will terminate abnormally. So who will take care of this situation? So system admin or server admin will be responsible to take care of this memory. I am being a programmer, I am not responsible to handle this situation because it not handled. So in exception we have also some child class. So one of the exception is called runtime exception, which is very popular. Runtime exception. So we have a several child class. One of the child class is called runtime exception. Runtime exception. Please keep that in mind or make a note that every time when I am talking about this exception, there is no space between the two word. So exception, runtime exception. Then we have a IO exception. SQL exception. Class not found exception. Okay, class not found exception, remote exception, class not found exception, not found exception, so many exception, that is remote exception. So many child class is present in exception class. Okay. So far we have discussed throwable inherited by two subclass. One of the class is called exception, another is called error, and these are the child class which is belongs to exception, runtime exception, IO exception, SQL exception, class not found exception, remote exception, so on. We have so many exception, and within this runtime exception we have some popular exception, that is one of the exception is called arithmetic exception, very popular. We are already familiar with this arithmetic exception. Null pointer exception. number format exception, number format exception. Acha, we have a class class exception, class class exception. We have another exception which is most popular, index out of bounds exception. Index out of bounds exception, not bound, bounds exception. Please keep that in mind. Every word is a starting letter is capital letter. Okay, number format exception, every letter is a capital letter. Out of bound exception, every first letter is a capital letter. Okay, next we have some exception like illegal argument exception, that is also one of the runtime exception. And we can also divide the index out of exception also two subclass. One of this called array index out of bound exception, array index out of bound exception. And another is string index. I'm just make it short, index out of bounds exception. Okay, so these are the runtime exception: arithmetic exception, null pointer exception, number format exception, class cast exception. These are the example of runtime exception. Okay, and we have also some IO exception, have some class, that is end of file exception. End of file exception, file not found exception. We have already discussed this file not found exception in our example. File not found exception, interrupted IO exception, okay. So this three exception classes belongs to IO exception. And we have also here the subclass of exception, that is interrupted exception. So here interrupted exception and here interrupted IO exception. So we have so many exception. And from error we have different error. One of the error is called, one of the error subclass is stack overflow. Most of the time we will get overflow error, virtual memory error. Virtual memory error, out of memory error, okay. We have another error also, we have also assertion error, exception initialization error. Okay, we have so many other error also. So throwable is the root class of any Java exception class. Okay, so it has a two subclass. One of the class is exception, and another class is error. And exception has so many subclasses: runtime exception, IO exception, SQL exception, class not found exception, interpreter exception, right? And runtime exception has some child classes. So arithmetic exception, null pointer exception, number format exception, class cast exception, index out of bound exception, and index out of bound exception are two types: array index out of bounds exception, string index out of bounds exception. And IO exception is end of file exception, file not exception, interpret exception, so many exception. And we have also seen so many error: stack overflow error, virtual memory error, out of memory error, assertion error, exception in initialization error, so many other error. So I want to say that exception can be handled, because we know already, we have already discussed how to handle the, or what is the mechanism how to handle this exception. But error cannot be handled, because error only caused by the what? Caused by the what? Lack of system resource. So is there any error happen in your program, so we can do, as being a programmer, we can do anything, right? So it is the responsibility of system admin or server admin to responsible to handle this situation. It is not our responsibility. So we only concentrate on exception. Now, next topic is, what is the difference between the check exception and uncheck exception? So we have seen so many exception, we have seen so many exception classes, but what is the difference between the check exception and uncheck exception? What is the difference between check exception, or we can say how many type of exception are available, or we can say check up type of exception. Okay, so check exception versus uncheck exception. So we have two type of exception. One is called check exception, another is called uncheck exception. Now, what is check exception? The exception which are checked by the compiler, please keep that in mind, which is checked by the compiler for smooth execution of the program at runtime are called check exception. Example, file not found exception. This is one of the example of check exception. Right? File not found exception is a check exception. End of file exception is a check exception. SQL exception is a check exception. Now, why I am talking in this way? Because check exception are those exception which has to check before execution of a program. Or is it, we can easily handle this situation. Suppose I am going to access some database, so I have to connect with Oracle database. So some might be happen that I am not able to connect my database, so some exception may be arise. So you already know that if I want to access a file, if the file is not present, some exception may be arise. You already know that. So if I want to access some input output operation, I want to perform some input output operation, and if I not got the input, some exception may be arise. So that kind of exception which may arise, you already know that, we have to handle or we have to check. So those exception which are checked by the compiler, so that during runtime the program execution program will flow in normal flow, that type of exception is called check exception. So in this exception hierarchy class, in this hierarchy class, so what are the check exception? So we already know that error cannot be handled, right? Know that error cannot be handled. So error, if error cannot be handled, it does not belongs to handling any exception handling mechanism, okay? And these are runtime exception, whatever the subclass is belongs to this runtime exception is uncheck exception. So only runtime exception is a uncheck exception. Uncheck means, it does not mean that we are not going to check. So I will get going to check at the runtime, and error is uncheck exception. So except runtime exception and error, everything, so IO exception, SQL exception, class not found exception, that are called check exception, because these are the situation is going to happen most of the time, because I am going to access a file, file may not be present, so check exception. So before that I have to write some code so that if there is an exception, how can handle it, we can handle it. So this most of the time this kind of exception arise so that we can check before that, write into program. So if I want to access any file in program, and if the handler code has been not written by the programmer, so automatically compiler will report that that unexpected exception in Java. Unexpected exception, that means I have not handled it, I have not written the code. So in our program, if there is a chance to writing the check exception, then compulsory we should handle this check exception either by try catch block or throws keyword, otherwise we will get a compile time error. I am not talking about that compiler will handle the exception or give the exception error. It's just only inform that kind of exception you may arise. So that's why I have used the term check by the compiler. So during the if in anywhere in our program, if there is a chance of rising the check exception, so we should compulsory handle this. Otherwise, compiler will give some message, or you can say compile time compilation error will happen, not exception, compiler error will happen, and it will report us that unreported exception in Java in which class. And uncheck exception which are not check by the compiler, whether the programmer handling or not, such type of exception are called uncheck exception. For example, arithmetic exception is a uncheck exception, null pointer exception is a uncheck exception, number format exception is a uncheck exception. So any exception which is belongs to runtime exception is uncheck exception. So it is not responsible for the compiler that whether the programmer is going to check or not, okay. So I hope this is clear to you. So for example, if I take a simple class, let me take a simple example so you can get that clear idea. For example, I have taken a class name is test, okay, and within this class I have taken public, static, void, main, string arx, I am not writing, just string arx to save some time. So I have taken a class print writer pw equal to new print writer. Suppose any class I am going to perform input output operation, so print writer, and I am going to write this txt. So text file, I am going to access a text file and I am going to write pw.println. Hello. So in this example, printwriter class is belongs to IO package. So I have to import this one, import java.io.star, right? So in this class, if I don't take any exception handling code, what will happen? First, it will report is a uncheck. It will give an error like compile error, unreported exception Java, unreported exception in Java. And what kind of error it may be arise? java.io.filenotfoundexception. Okay, file not found exception, then you will give the message must be caught or declare to thrown. And at a time, so this is compile time exception, sorry, right? So check exception, if I don't care about the check exception, if I don't handle this check exception, what will happen? The compiler will give me the error. Suppose I have handled this check exception, and in the meantime, after this line, I want to add additional line dot, for example, system.out.println. Suppose I want to 10 by 0, or you can write 50 by 0. So I am going to divide a number by 0. So what will happen? That will not check by the compiler. So this, what kind of error it is? It is a arithmetic exception. So it should be checked by the programmer by using try catch block. So it's an example of check exception. Though the code has been written, only have just used the try catch block to handle this file not out exception, or you can say the check exception, but uncheck exception will be handled at the runtime by the programmer. So whether is a check or uncheck exception occur at runtime only, there is no chance of exception occur at compile time. I have just mentioned that check by the compiler, it does not mean that check at compile time. So only check at runtime. Okay. Now the next question is fully checker and partially checker exception. So we already know the check exception, and what is next term is fully check exception and partially check exception. So one of the term is fully check exception versus partially check exception. So look at this hierarchy class. So a check exception is said to be if and only if its child class also check, right? So in this example, this is check exception, but I want to say that if and only all its child class also check. For example, end of file exception, file not found exception, interpret IO exception, every time every child class also has to be checked if this kind of exception arise. So it's a fully check exception. But look at this, in the exception class, this is uncheck exception, runtime exception is uncheck exception, and all the remaining exception are check exception. So it combination of check exception and uncheck exception. So one of the child class consists of check exception and some of the class consists of uncheck exception. One of the class runtime exception is a check exception and uncheck exception, and all the remaining class are check exception. So it's a combination of both. So not all the child class doing the same thing. So it is a uncheck exception, a partially check exception. So what are the example of partially check exception? One of the example is exception. Exception class itself is a partially check exception, because its child class, one of the child class is not fully check, but rest of the class may be fully check, but one of the class is not fully check. So similarly, same rules, the throwable is a superclass of exception class. So throwable is the partially check exception class. So only two class, please keep that in mind. Only two class, only the exception class and throwable class is the example of partially check exception. And all the remaining check exception are fully check exception class. So in this lecture, I have just discussed about the hierarchy of Java exception classes. What is check exception? What is uncheck exception? What is the difference between the exception and error? What is the difference between the fully check exception and partially check exception? And also that example, in case of fully check exception example, we got the exception, IO exception, interrupted exception, SQL exception. These are the fully check exception example, and partially check exception example, exception, error, exception and throwable. Only two, please keep that in mind. And the next lecture, I will discuss about the try clutch block, how we can handle by using customized try clutch block. Then I will discuss about what are the method to print the exception information, how can we use a single try clutch block with multiple catch block. So that means one try block with multiple catch block, and we will explain the try catch flow of execution of a program. Everything I will cover in the next lecture. Thank you.